Hi, my name is Deepak Shivastwa, and in this demonstration, we will help and understand configuring remote desktop services on Windows Azure infrastructure as a service. Windows Azure is an open and flexible cloud platform that enables you to quickly build, deploy, and manage applications across a global network of Microsoft-managed data centers. So over the internet, the end user can deploy virtual machines and install applications inside that, or he or she can directly create services on Windows Azure-based cloud. When we are trying to integrate the concept of remote desktop services, aka RDS, on Azure, then there are a lot of configuration scenarios. Assume a scenario A where there is an end customer and he is trying to configure RDS on Azure, and he is configuring everything on the Azure-based cloud, including his Active Directory and all the RDS-based roles, like web access, connection broker, or the session host. There could be a scenario B where the end user is having on-premises Active Directory domain, as well as he is trying to create Active Directory onto the Azure-based cloud. There could be a third scenario, which is a combination of scenario A and B, where the end customer will be having on-premises Active Directory, as well as he wants his end user to access RDS on Azure over the internet. We have to also understand the difference between a typical VDI and a session virtualization. VDI stands for Virtual Desktop Infrastructure, which provides you the capability to access full client desktop-based virtual machines. However, session virtualization provides capability in which single server desktop is being shared via sessions. There are a lot of components of the remote desktop services, and each and every component plays a specific job. Remote desktop web access is a role which provides you the capability to get a web interface and let the end user to access the RDS-based environment. Remote desktop gateway is a server where we configure the wrap and the cap policies. Remote desktop connection broker is a server which provides you the capability for session reconnections as well as fair share. Remote desktop licensing server is a role where we configure all our licenses. Remote desktop virtualization host is a role which is configured on a physical host to create the virtual machines in a typical VDI scenario. And when we are talking about integrating RDS and Azure, remote desktop virtualization host is not required here. Last but not the least is remote desktop session host. Remote desktop session host provides the capability for the end user to connect to the servers as well as connect to the remote apps. These all infrastructure is not only accessible from the Microsoft-based devices, it is also feasible to access it over the cross platforms, like Mac or the iOS. Let's understand how to configure the complete infrastructure, which is RDS on Windows Azure. Let's log into windowsazure.com and click on Portal. Enter the credentials. Click on Sign In. It will take a little while, and we can see the Azure-based portal in front of us. The first thing that we need to do is to configure the network and the virtual machines. In order to create virtual machines, we click on Compute, go to option called Virtual Machine. We have two options now, either Quick Create or from the gallery. If we want Quick Create, then it's a simple wizard. However, if we want customization, we have to choose the option from gallery. We can select the image to be deployed from, select the version release date, give the virtual machine name, credentials to logged in, click Next. Either we can use an existing cloud service or we can create a new cloud service. And accordingly, we can configure the affinity group and the availability sets. The endpoint can be configured at the later stage as well. And click OK to deploy the virtual machine. In a similar fashion, the other virtual machines needs to be deployed, and each virtual machine will be responsible for one specific job, like web access, connection broker, session host. And if the customer is hosting everything on Windows Azure, then we have to create a virtual machine to install and configure Active Directory as well. In a similar fashion, we are deploying the other virtual machine like AD101, where we are configuring the Active Directory role. CB101 is the connection broker server, SH101 is session host server, and WA101 is a web access and a gateway server. On web access and the gateway server, we have to configure the endpoints as well. The endpoints are port 443 and 3389. Once all endpoint and the servers are configured, they are joined to the part of one single Active Directory domain. The next thing that needs to be done is to configure and install the remote desktop services on the servers like CB101, SH101 and WA101. It's a simple wizard to follow to install and configure the roles inside all the servers. We have to take an RDP and install the roles. Select the server, click Connect. It will install our RDP file. Click OK and enter the credentials to log in. Now, once we log into the server and install and configure RDS role, we can also see in the overview wizard that which server is holding what role. The second step is to follow is to create the collections. We click on the collections tab, choose create session collection, click next, give it a name like collection 01, select the available RD session host server, click next. We can define which user can access our collections. If we want, we can enable or disable the user profile desk. It can be configured later as well. Select Next, click Create. It will take a little while and it will create the collection and add the available session host server. And once the collection has been created, the next job is to publish the applications inside that. There you go, close, and I can see my collection 01 got created. Select on collection 01. We get an option to publish the remote apps. We click on publish remote app program. It will populate the list of applications available. Let's select calculator, paint, remote desktop connections, or you can choose other as well. Click next, publish. If we want to publish more applications or to unpublish the published applications, we can do that as well. And once the application has been published, we will open the web interface. The URL of the web interface will be the server which is holding web access role. There you go. Click close. Open Internet Explorer page. This is my web access server name, followed by REWeb. Enter the credential. Sign in. I can see the applications available here. Click on the any of the application and the application will get open up in front of us. When the user is trying to open the application for the very first time, it will take a little while to create the user profile. And this application is open up. Similarly, we can access the other applications as well. Now, we have to explore the complete capability of RDS on Azure over the internet using cloud services. Now, let's try to access our remote app over the internet. I give a URL, the name of my cloud service name, followed by REWeb, enter my credentials, give it a password, enter sign in, I can see my applications listed here. And as and when I click on the any of the application, it get open up. So the complete idea of the RDS on Windows Azure is you are hosting your infrastructure on Azure-based cloud, you are publishing your applications there, you are maintaining a session connections, and you are allowing the end user to connect to them over the internet. And if you want to rename the specific URL, that is rds101.cloudapp.net, you can redirect to your company given name like abc.com. So let me click on the calculator application and open it up. Click on the connect. Now the application will get opened up, and in a similar fashion we can access the other applications as well. This covers the access of the remote app. In a similar fashion, we can access the server-based environment as well, that is session host servers. This covers configuring remote desktop services on Windows Azure. It provides you the capability to access your remote app and the session host servers. To get access, to get certified, and to get trained, please follow the links mentioned here. Thank you and have a nice day.